Morning all of you. Today we are going to learn about laminar airflow. Actually this practical is embedded in the instruments. First, that is the demonstration of instruments. In that we learn about the hot air oven, incubator and autoclave. Today we are going to learn about the laminar airflow. Okay, so what is laminar airflow? This is laminar airflow, or it is also called as the unidirectional airflow. Okay, it means the straight and uninterrupted airflow. Okay, laminar airflow cabinets are generally used where protection is required for the work and product only. So why we are going to use the laminar airflow? Because we require a area which is free from microorganism. For that we require the laminar airflow. Okay, the laminar airflow cabinets are generally used where the protection is required for the work or product only. There are two types are generally available for laminar airflow. They are horizontal as well as vertical. So first we will see what is the working principle of this laminar airflow. The laminar, see here in this slide it is given, the laminar hood is made up of stainless steel avoiding joints and corners to prevent the accumulation of the bacterial spores. This device creates a sterile environment with the flow of the sterile air through the high efficiency particulate air, that is the HEPA filter, and shortwave ultraviolet germicidal lamp that sterilizes the workstation. The laminar airflow has to turn on 15 minutes before to ensure complete sterilization, and the workstation should be cleaned with the ethanol before and after use. Okay, so in this laminar airflow we require the, there is a provision of light is there, that is the ultraviolet light is there, and there is a presence of HEPA filter. On the presence of this HEPA filter or airflow, there are the types of horizontal as well as vertical HEPA filters. We will see that, but before going towards its types, we are going to learn this principle. And in principle we learn that there are two things are there, ultraviolet light, which are going to kill the microorganisms, okay, which is present, which are going to kill the spores. Okay, and the high efficiency particulate air, that is HEPA filters, are they are providing the airflow within this high airflow to sterilize the air also. Okay, and by this way the cabinet become sterile, germ free. Okay, any type of organisms, bacteria, viruses are not present there. Why? Because we are using the UV light as well as the HEPA filter. Okay, so what is the horizontal? The main HEPA filter is placed immediately behind the working area. I'm repeating, the horizontal, the main HEPA filter is placed immediately behind the working area in a vertical position. Clean air is blown normally at 0.45 meter per second across the work surface towards the operator. Okay, it is placed behind the working area, a vertical position. Clean air is blown normally at 0.45 meter per second. Okay, and what is meant by the vertical? The main HEPA filter is placed immediately above the working area. Okay, means upstreams. The clean air is blown normally 0.35 meter per second vertically down over the surface area. Okay, so this is the laminar airflow. By this way we can kill certain all types of bacteria. Okay, so what are the applications of this laminar airflow? The laminar airflow is required to quality control labs of pharmaceutical industries or in food industries also it is important, as well as in microbiology it is very important to maintain the aseptic area. This laminar airflow is required, and quality control labs of micro circuits, electronic assembly and manufacturing of applications it is required. So in biotechnology also this laminar airflow is very helpful. So this is all about the laminar airflow. Now we will see in this slide it is given the figure, slide number 4, the figure of laminar airflow is given, its parts also given. And now we will see the microscope. The microscope is the main part of microbiology. Okay, we learn the microscope in theory also. So what is the microscope? See here it is, in the figure it is given. So the microscope, what is the principle of microscope? It forms the real inverted magnified image of an object. It is the principle of microscope. What is the microscope? Microscope is an optical instrument which uses the visible light and system lenses to view the magnified images of very small object. Okay, microscope is an instrument, optical instrument, which uses the visible light and system lenses to view the magnified images, not only magnified real inverted images of small object. Okay, and we learn the two types of microscope, that is the light or compound microscope as well as the electron microscope. Okay, so this is all about, and what is the principle, as I told you. Okay, so This microscopes are having different types: simple microscope, compound microscope and electron microscope. What is simple microscope? It has one set of the lens and low magnification power. It is the simple microscope. What is the compound microscope? It has two set of lenses and objective with higher magnification. And electron microscope, it differs from the optical microscope in that the electrons interact with the sample to generate the image instead of the light acting as an illuminated source. So here in electron microscope we are using the electron beam. Okay, in compound microscope we uses the visible light. Okay, the general light for the magnification purpose. But in electron we are going to take the electron beam instead of light. Okay, so this is the difference between the electron microscope and compound microscope. The physical terms, that is the what are the parts of the microscope. There are support system is given in this figure. It is given complete microscope and its parts. There is a support system is there, illuminating system is there, magnification system is there, and adjustment system is there. This support system, it is consist of the various parts which are like base of microscope, pillars of microscope, handle or arm of microscope, body tube is there, okay, stage is there, and nose piece is there. Okay, and talking about the adjustment system, there is a coarse adjustment is there, fine adjustment is there. And what about the illuminating system? The illuminating system is a good illuminating system is the one which provides the uniform and bright illumination of entire field viewed under the microscope. Okay, so it is the illuminating system, and on the basis of that there is a bright field microscope, dark field microscope, fluorescent microscope is there. And these are about the illuminating system, and the condenser is also there. The condenser is the main. The rays of light reflected by the mirror pass through the condenser located in between the mirrors and the stage of the microscope, then fall onto the object under the examination, and thus the help in the resolving of the image. Okay, so this is about the microscope. In microscope, in compound microscope particularly, it is an arrangement of the objective and eyepiece uses to magnify an object to observe the animalcules or to observe the certain microfloras. Okay, so this is about the microscope. See here, it is given in the principle of the microscope, working principle. There are many different types of microscope, each of which works on the respective principles. However, there is some common terms are there. The basic principle in the microscope is magnification based on the relative position of the objective from the lens or electromagnets. Different positions, nature, magnification of the image can be achieved. Different types of microscopes are developed to cater to the specific needs of the observations. However, the common theme is magnifying. Okay, so actually the principle of microscope, as I told you, the microscope is an optical instrument which uses the visible light and lens system, and by this way we can observe the magnified images. But by the microscope we are not observing only magnified images, we are observing the real magnified and inverted image of an object. This is the principle of microscope. Okay, and in detail we'll learn in the theory also. So what are the uses of this microscope? The uses of microscope is that to observe the certain types of microflora, to study the morphological characters of the microorganisms. Okay, these are the certain types of these are the certain applications of the microscope. Okay, so there is one more instrument in your practical, that is the deep freezer is there, or a refrigerator. So all you know what are the refrigeration process or why the refrigerator is used. So the principle of refrigerator is it can keep the substance as it is. Okay, so this is the principle. The mechanical energy is utilized to achieve the refrigeration. A compressor is used to increase the temperature and pressure of the refrigeration vapor. And why we are going to use the refrigerator? Because it can keep the thing as it is. Okay. So when we keep our fully grown culture into the refrigerator at that time, it can be stored or it can be preserved that culture for 1 week. Okay, so this is why we are going to use the refrigerator. Okay, so this is all about your instruments, important instruments. I hope you all understood these instruments. So thank you.